reaction R turning to P, the rate of reaction is equal to minus delta R over delta T, or rate of reaction can also be equal to delta P over delta T. I hope it is clear to you here. Now we see here where delta R gives the decrease in the concentration of R, and delta P represents increase in concentration of P. The square brackets are used to express the molar concentration, that is in moles per liter. It may be noted that in case of concentration of reactants, minus sign is used. I told you that we put a minus sign before the reactants. This implies that the concentration of reactant is decreasing with time. For example, I have this equation. I can write the rate 2 and 2 are the stoichiometric coefficients. So rate of reaction will be equal to minus half delta N2 of phi over delta T is equal to half delta N2 over delta T is equal to delta O2 over delta T. See here, minus sign before the reactants. Again, I have the equation. PCl5 gas gives you PCl3 gas plus Cl2 gas. The rate of reaction R over R is equal to minus delta PCl5 over delta T. That is equal to delta PCl3 over delta T. That is equal to delta Cl2. Delta Cl2 over delta T. Now we come to the two types of rates, that is the average rate and the instantaneous rate. The two equations I told you earlier, please see the video. Equation number 1 and 2, they represent the average rate of reaction. So, equation 1 and 2 gives the average rate of reaction over the time interval delta T. This may be expressed as rate equal to change in concentration upon time taken. That is equal to delta X upon delta T. The rate of reaction may also be expressed at a particular moment of time. Thus, rate of reaction R over R may also be defined as the rate of change of concentration of any one of the reactants or products at a given time. Such a reaction rate is known as, I like here, instantaneous rate. Very, very important. It's known as instantaneous rate of reaction. To express the instantaneous rate of reaction, the time interval delta T is made as small as possible so that rate of reaction R over R remains almost constant during that time interval, and the rate may be represented by minus dR over dt or dP over dt instead of minus delta R over delta T or delta P over delta T respectively. Here dR or dP represents infinitesimally small changes in concentration of R or P in infinitesimally small interval of time dT. Thus, the average rate approaches the instantaneous rate as delta T becomes smaller and smaller. I can write minus delta R over delta T. Delta T tends to 0. Limit delta T tends to 0 becomes minus dR over dt. And delta P over delta T, limit delta T tends to 0 is equal to dP over dt. One more thing.
My next video,
I will give you examples. Thank you.